Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. Like I'm not the first to come this way, and this guy never found the way out. I guess I don't really have any choice.
God! Oh my God.
Oh.
Ethan. Ethan, can you hear me?
You've got a hell of a fever.
I'm gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds. Arms look really bad. I need to disinfect your wounds. I'm not a doctor, but I'll do what I can. Your wounds are disinfected. He's unconscious. Now I'll just have to wait and hope he wakes up. How do you feel?
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel act? You don't even know me.
You didn't really leave me any choice. I couldn't just leave you like that.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. It's the kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but, it's not easy. That's the second time I found you in a bad way. You always seem to be running for your life. What's happening, Ethan? I'm sorry. I shouldn't be asking you questions. I mean, after all, we hardly know each other. You have no reason to trust me.
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me.
You've already done a lot, Madison.
Right. I'm gonna go. Take care.
I didn't do it. I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no? Then why did you run away when they came to question you?
I already told you I forgot to report to my parole officer. I didn't want to go back to prison. When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
We checked out his statement. He has an alibi for at least three of the murders.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
Ash? Okay. Sean Moss's mother's here. She'd like to speak with you.
It was a few months back. The middle of the night. It was pouring down. Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been. He spoke about drowning the rain. He didn't make any sense. There was something in his eyes. As if it wasn't really him. There may be no connection, but the next day there was that announcement about another victim of the origami killer. Find my son. I'm begging you.
I'm Police Lieutenant Carter Blake, and this is Agent Norman Jaden of the FBI. According to our information, Ethan Mars is one of your patients. We'd like to ask you a few questions about him.
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
I beg your pardon?
I'm bound by an oath of secrecy. Under no circumstances may I discuss my patients.
My job is to find Sean Mars alive, and I don't give a damn about any bullshit oath.
I know you don't want to protect a murderer. If you know anything, you must tell us, Doctor.
I'm sorry. I can't help you. And now I must ask you to leave.
You need to cooperate. For your own sake.
It's your duty to inform the police if you suspect one of your patients, Doctor.
Are you threatening me?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc. I suggest you take it.
Blake! That's enough. Let's get out of here.
I am going to call the police and make a complaint about your behavior.
Doctor, you are really pushing my buttons. The only thing I'm interested in is saving that kid's life. So, you're gonna be a good boy and tell me what I want to know, or I am really gonna lose my temper.
Blake, stop that! Immediately!
Let go of me! You have no right!
Come on, Doc. There's an easy way and a hard way. It's your fucking choice.
You have no right to hit him.
I'm saving a kid's life, for Christ's sake. If you don't like it, leave.
If you don't let go of this man immediately, I'll report you and you'll be off the case.
What the hell's the matter with you, Norman? What, you getting cold feet? You don't want to save Sean Mars anymore?
I want to save Sean Mars just as much as you do, but that doesn't give me all rights. So you're gonna stop this shit right now!
Ethan Mars has had psychological problems since his first son died. Feels responsible for his death. A sort of morbid neurosis. He is haunted by visions of drowning bodies. A few weeks ago, after one of our usual sessions, I found this on the floor. It must have fallen out of his pocket.
Ash, I want you to assign every available man to finding Ethan Mars. I want a man outside his place day and night. Notify all agencies to start looking for him. I want you to keep an eye on the train stations, the airports, the bus terminals. I want every cop in the city on his ass, so that if he moves, we know about it. Yes, Ethan Mars is the Origami Killer.
Nice shot.
Thank you. Please come in, Mr. Shelby. Would you care for a coffee?
Oh, no thanks.
Do you play?
I tried once, but I think the owner of the course is still looking for me.
It's an interesting sport. It requires strength, but also a cool head and absolute precision. Would you care to hit a few balls with me? There's no danger of damaging the greens here.
Okay.
Take off your jacket and grab a club. The balls are in that basket. The most important thing is to grip the club correctly. When you feel ready, you swing. Hell, it's only your first ball. You should try to strike it a little harder next time.
I'm assuming you didn't invite me here just to play golf, Mr. Kramer.
I hear you've been asking questions about my son.
That's right. I want to know if Gordy is linked to the Origami Killer case in any way.
My son had nothing to do with that sordid case.
Well, then he has nothing to fear from my investigation.
You have no business investigating my son. I told you, he had nothing to do with it.
With all due respect, Mr. Kramer, it's up to me to decide who I want to investigate.
I'm an influential man, Mr. Shelby, and I pay very well for loyalty.
Are you trying to buy me?
Let's just say I'm trying to show you where your interest lies. How much do you want to leave my son alone?
I think you misunderstood me. I don't play that game.
Don't go near my son, Mr. Shelby. If you do, you'll regret it.
Have a nice day, Mr. Kramer.